of Foreign Language of Indira Gandhi National Open University presents a program on familiarization of French language for the beginners of language learning students.
Bonjour, ça va aujourd'hui?
Oui, très bien.
Très bien.
On prépare notre émission de radio pour Galliani en français.
Oui, c'est super.
Et de quoi on parle dans cette émission? De tout ce qu'on a déjà vu. Comment dire bonjour, se présenter, poser des questions, tout un programme. En effet, il y a du travail.
Do you know in which language these people are talking? Is it Spanish, Swedish, Russian or any other language? This is French language. Today our topic is the verbs used in the sentences when introducing yourself. Listen to different sentences using the verb
être.
We can translate this verb by to be, but its use depends on the context. For example, you can say I am French.
Je suis français.
But sometimes we use another verb to translate to be in French. For example, you have to translate I am 30 years by
J'ai 30 ans
and not
Je suis 30 ans.
Here we use the French verb
avoir.
Now listen to these different sentences using the verb
être.
Hello Sushant, where are you? Salut Sushant, où es-tu?
I'm in the library, do you want to come? Je suis à la bibliothèque, veux-tu venir?
No, I have to meet Thomas, he is in Paris too with his sister. Non, je dois voir Thomas. Il est à Paris aussi, avec sa sœur.
Oh great! Where are they right now? Oh super! Où sont-ils maintenant?
I don't know yet. Je ne sais pas encore.
Okay, so call me when you are together, I can join you. D'accord, alors appelle-moi quand vous êtes ensemble, je peux vous rejoindre. In this conversation, you have heard each form of the verb être. In present, let us repeat. I am is like.
Je suis.
We are is.
Nous sommes.
You are is.
Tu es.
If you speak to one friend, or if you speak to several people, or if you are using a respectable form, you use.
Vous êtes.
So, you are is.
Tu es.
And also.
Vous êtes.
He is translated.
Il est. Ils sont.
Is plural of he is. That is, they are. For they are, we say.
Ils sont.
She is translated as.
Elle est.
And for plural, they are in feminine is.
Elles sont.
Let us listen again to the same conversation in French only.
Salut Sushant, où es-tu?
Je suis à la bibliothèque. Veux-tu venir?
Non, je dois voir Thomas. Il est à Paris avec sa sœur.
Oh super, où sont-ils maintenant?
Je ne sais pas encore.
D'accord. Alors, appelle-moi quand vous êtes ensemble, je peux vous rejoindre. Now you know how to use the verb to be, être. In present, which is useful to introduce yourself, the verb
être
is also used to speak about your state of mind or health, about your location, etc. Now we want to talk about some polite forms of uses in France. This is really important in France and it is important to use polite forms of language when you meet someone for the first time. In English, you always use you to speak to someone. If you are talking to several persons or if you are talking to one friend or to your director, you always use you. In France, you have to pay attention. You is translated as
tu
if you are talking to a friend or
vous
if you are talking to several persons or to a person you have to show respect. Let us listen to a conversation between two people who are using polite forms. Good morning, madam. Can you help me, please? Bonjour, madame. Pouvez-vous m'aider, s'il vous plaît?
Yes, of course. Tell me. Oui, bien sûr. Dites-moi.
I'm lost. I want to go to the cinema, but I don't remember where it is. Je suis perdu. Je veux aller au cinéma, mais je ne sais pas plus. Je ne sais plus où c'est. Je suis perdu. Je veux aller au cinéma, mais je ne sais plus où c'est.
It's just the next road on your left. C'est juste la prochaine route à gauche.
Ok, thank you so much for your help. D'accord, merci beaucoup pour votre aide.
You're welcome. Have a good day. De rien. Bonne journée.
Goodbye, au revoir. So in this conversation, a man asks information to a woman he does not know. For this reason, he has to use polite words like s'il vous plaît, merci beaucoup. But they also use the polite forms
vous.
For this reason, he has to use polite words like
s'il vous plaît, merci beaucoup.
But they also use the polite form
vous.
Let us listen again to the same conversation in French only. Pay attention to the politeness words. Bonjour madame, pouvez-vous m'aider s'il vous plaît?
Oui, bien sûr. Dites-moi.
Je suis perdu. Je vais aller au cinéma, mais je ne sais plus où c'est.
C'est juste la prochaine route à gauche.
D'accord. Merci beaucoup pour votre aide.
De rien. Bonne journée.
Au revoir. In this program, we have revised how to give self-introduction. You have learned how to speak in a polite way, using vous and other words. And you have learned to spell words and the way to pronounce the alphabet in French. Let us say it again to see if you remember it.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
Let us also check if you know how to conjugate the verb
être
in present form.
Je suis, nous sommes, tu es, vous êtes, il est.
To speak about one person who is male.
Ils sont.
To speak about several men.
Elle est.
To speak about one female.
Elles sont.
To speak about several women. Try to say it at the same time as us.
Je suis. Nous sommes. Tu es. Vous êtes. Il est. Ils sont. Elle est. Elles sont.
Now let us talk about some cultural aspects of France. There are three important words in French national heritage. Liberté, égalité, fraternité. Liberty, equality, fraternity. These three words mean liberty, equality, fraternity. They constitute the motto of the French Republic. It appeared for the first time at the end of the 18th century during the French Revolution. It is said that the first one to use this motto was Robespierre, a French lawyer really involved in the French Revolution. It took time to have an entire place among the French symbols and was finally clearly accepted during the Third Republic, which began in 1840. Today, you can read these words on public buildings and also on French postal stamps. At the beginning of the 20th century, these words were also inscribed on French coins and they still appear on some euros.
You are just listening to a program entitled The Verbs Used in the Sentences When Introducing Yourself to Learn French Language Through English. In this program, you're able to understand the verbs used in the sentences when introducing yourself. In this program, we have revised how to give self-introduction. You have learned how to speak in a polite way using
vous
and other words, and you have learned to spell words and the way to pronounce the alphabet in French. Let's say it again to see if you remember it.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z.
Now let's talk about some cultural aspects of France. There's a famous liquor called Chartreux, which is spelled as in France. There is a kind of mystery about this liquor because the recipe is a secret. Actually, this liquor was made by monks in the 18th century with extracts of different plants. More than 100 different plants were used in it. It is said that the recipe of the elixir, which is the basis of this liquor, was invented in the 17th century. In this program, the participants were Juliet Aracle, Lalema Aneja Dang, D. Andrews, Dr. Sushant Kumar Mishra, Isora Buisson Brule, and Tiffane Amar. Program concept and scripted by Manoj Kumar Singh, Dr. Sushant Kumar Mishra, and Isora Buisson Brule. Program content coordinator, Dr. Sushant Kumar Mishra. Sound recording by Parvesh Kumari and edited by Sadhan Lal. Produced by Manoj Kumar Singh. This program was brought to you by Electronic Media Production Center of the Indira Gandhi National Open University.
Did you know? The banyan or Indian fig tree is considered a symbol of immortality and is mentioned in many Indian myths and legends. This self-renewing plant is India's national tree. Interesting facts brought to you by NCITE in collaboration with EMPC Division, IGNU. Thank you.